Hi, Ken Rohla here with freshandalive.com, and once again I'm here with you to answer the many questions that we get, or I should say some of the many questions that we get through our website and phone. I want to get these videos out to you on a more regular basis. I know it's been a long time since I've updated my YouTube channel, and I apologize for that, but I have spent a lot of my time developing solutions or finding solutions for really serious threats to our health, like radioactivity. You know, I don't know if you realize it or not, but we've got nuclear fallout from not just Fukushima, but also Chernobyl and other many other sources coming down on us. And it's kind of reaching a fever pitch around the world, and it's coming down on our food, it's getting into our water supplies, and we've got to do things to protect ourselves. So we'll have some videos and more information about that. But I've spent a lot of my time working on these threats. Biowarfare agents is another one I've spent a lot of time working on. And, you know, it's not always easy to come up with solutions for these things, but there always is a solution. And the reason is because consciousness creates reality. And that's one huge trump card that we have that I want to remind you of. And keep that within your heart and within your mind, that it doesn't matter what horrible thing comes along, we always have solutions for them, because the way consciousness creates reality. You know, the energies of consciousness is scalar energy. And this scalar energy that we capture with pyramids and organite devices and things like that, what we're really capturing is God consciousness. It's the consciousness coming from the center of the universe, coming from the centers of galaxies, being relayed to us, and we can capture it and do things with it. And in fact, that's what we do. You know, the Bible says we're the hands of God. Well, we really are. You've got this whole universe is a big fractal matter energy system, and this energy is being relayed from large branches to small branches. A fractal is just a branching. So this energy that's coming from the centers of the galaxy to us, we're receivers of it and transmitters of it. And so that's how consciousness creates reality in a really, really simple nutshell. We capture this God consciousness and we rebroadcast it, and we use it to create the matter and energy around us and manipulate it, and particularly within the body. So if you see a problem like the Fukushima disaster or geoengineering pollutants or genetically engineered biowarfare agents or whatever, know there's already a solution out there, because the polarities of this energy that has created the problem, the opposite polarities always create the solution. So I want to really impress that upon you. I see a lot of people who have given up hope and are depressed, and particularly on social media like Facebook, I see a lot of people that just feel like there's no hope for us on this planet. And there's absolutely hope for us on this planet. It's the best time to be alive on this planet, because there's never been more opportunities for happiness and health and success as there have been for misery and pain. So, you know, focus on that positive, and not just focus on the positive, but get clear intentions, get clear about what you want, and then when you have a problem come up, look for the solution. You've got Google, the great Oracle Google, sitting out there, and all you have to do is a few magical hand movements and you can find out what you need to know. You know, you can find me. Here I am on YouTube, right? So you create your reality, you can create these solutions, or you can find these solutions. And there are, I guarantee you, the moment that the problem is being created, there are already people working on the solution and coming up with it. So I spend a lot of my time looking for the solutions. So I've got a question today about one of those solutions, which is a really cool one. It's a very empowering one. And the question is, how do I use EM1 and EMPRO, and what's the difference? Okay, first of all, what is that? What does that mean, EM1? EM stands for Effective Microorganisms, and that is a blend of beneficial microbes that was developed by an agricultural professor from Japan named Teruo Higa. That's T-E-R-U-O-H-I-G-A, Teruo Higa. You can see this on our website and on my blog and places where I talk about them. And Teruo Higa, back in the 1960s, was working on, he was a conventional chemical agricultural teacher, and he was looking for ways to use microbes to enhance agriculture. And he tried a litany of different microbes to try and improve agriculture and got nowhere. And he spent decades, I think 20, 30 years, banging his head against the wall, getting nowhere with this, because he was trying to find this one microbe that could be used and hopefully patented to improve agricultural results and growth in plants. And he failed miserably because what he didn't know at the time was that what you need is not just one microbe, you need a synergistic blend of microbes. So after decades of failure trying this microbe and that microbe and disgust, he threw out all of his experiments and gave up on it. And apparently he threw his experiments out on a compost pile, and the compost pile just took off. It broke down really fast and all kinds of life started popping up and growing up out of it. And so he realized, like, wait a minute, it's the synergistic blend of microbes. And so he wound up developing that synergistic blend of microbes into what he calls effective microorganisms. And it turns out you can do a lot of amazing things with microbes. You know, I had my friend Victoris Kolvinskis, the co-founder of Hippocrates Health Institute, visiting here one day. And he said, you know, it's microbes that are going to take us out, and it's microbes that will save us. Meaning that, you know, if we keep polluting this planet and living the way we are out of balance with nature, we're going to create so many superbugs and toxins that they'll kill us off. But at the same time, for those who are aware, they can use beneficial microbes, probiotics, to save themselves, save ourselves. So Teruo Higa recognized that, developed this product, and it's so ridiculously simple to make that that's one of the things that I teach. And the applications for it are far and wide, really, really broad range of applications for this stuff. For example, in agriculture, you can take these microbes and mix it with many thousands of parts of water to one part of these microbes. You can spray them on soil, and they will get into soil, and they will break down minerals and nutrients and make them bioavailable to plants. And they will improve the flora in soil. You know, soil is not meant to be dead and full of chemicals. Soil is meant to be a living ecosystem full of microbes and insects and life that create nutrients for plants and deliver them to plants. Soil is also a network of roots and mycelium from fungi that break down minerals and deliver those nutrients to the plant roots. And also, plant roots and mycelium are a communication system under the soil that allow plants to communicate with each other. Plants actually work synergistically to help each other out. And this is being proven. This is not just me saying this. This is being proven. And if we had more time, I'd give you more information about that. But if you watch my blog post and you watch my website, you'll see more about this. So anyway, these microbes in agriculture, you can put them on soil. You can actually spray the plants with them. And if you've got mold or mildew on the plants, it will eat the mold and mildew and kill it and make the plant healthier. It helps deliver nutrients to the roots of the plant. And it breaks down toxins in soil, which is really, really cool. Or in water. If you've got a polluted lake, you can put these microbes in the lake and it will break these toxins down into non-toxic elements. And this has been proven over and over again. Teruo Higa has shown this over and over again. And he actually has these gatherings that you can go to where he will take his effective microorganisms, very, very dilute form, and put it into mud and make mud balls. And they let the mud balls dry and harden, and then they toss them out into lakes and rivers, and they sink down to the bottom, and they spread these microbes throughout the body of water, and the microbes will propagate, and they will eat and break toxins down, and you get clean, pure water again. And this is one of the things you can do with, a farm pond, or a river. You can put these things into bodies of water, and you can clean these things up. Now, here's the cool thing. You can make these yourself. You can ferment these microbes yourself, and you can make huge batches of them. And because they're so dilute, you're only using like a teaspoon or a tablespoon per gallon of water at most in these agricultural applications. And so you can make gallons and gallons of this stuff very, very simply just by taking a quart of molasses, 5 gallons of water, and a quart of the EM microbes. You just mix it all up, seal it up, and brew it like beer. You can go to homebrew stores and get these beer brewing kits, and you can use it for the EM. And you can get like 5 gallons of this brew for under $50, which you can then dilute tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of times to water. And you can use it, as I mentioned, for agriculture. You can use it for gardening. You can use it indoors. It's a mold and mildew remover. It eats moldy mildew for breakfast. So you can put this stuff in your house. You can dilute it and spray it around your house as a household cleaner. You can put it in the shower and it will eat mold and mildew and soap scum out of your shower. It's amazing stuff. It's an odor eliminator. So if you've got pet stains or pet odors in your carpet or around your house, spray this stuff on it, kills the odors dead. If you've got a moldy, nasty, stinky air conditioner, spray it in the air conditioner, open that air conditioner up. I'm gonna do another video where I'm gonna show you mold being eaten away by effective microorganisms in an air conditioning unit. When I first moved to my current house, we put in a big, very expensive air conditioning system, and within a few months, here in Florida, it was full of mold. And I had replaced all the ductwork, you know, we'd done all this stuff, really expensive. And I looked at that and I went, let's try some EM. So I sprayed it full strength inside this air conditioning unit, came back 2 weeks later, opened it up, and all the mold was gone. And I don't mean it killed it and it left it sitting there like bleach does. It ate it for breakfast. It wasn't even there anymore. So I was elated. And of course, you know, I sprayed it, I misted it into the intake of the air conditioner. I took the filter out, the air filter out, ran the air conditioner and misted it into the intake, and it blew it through all of the ductwork. And guess what? The ductwork cleared up. So it's really amazing stuff, really cool stuff, lots of applications. You can use it as an engine degreaser. But here's a really, really cool one you can do. Let's say you're out gardening and you're growing organically and it rains and nuclear fallout comes down on your garden. And you say, what? That doesn't happen. Oh, yes, it does. It happens all the time, all across the world, especially the Northern Hemisphere. There's lots and lots of nuclear fallout coming down. All you've got to do is go online and Google cesium-137 in water, or uranium in water, or plutonium, or name your favorite radioactive element in water supplies. Just Google that and you'll see all across the United States the EPA is finding these radioactive elements in food supplies and water supplies. So you can take these microbes and spray your yard with it. You can put it in water and it will break these radioactive elements down into non-toxic elements. Yes, it does transmutation of elements, which actually is no big deal. It's not alchemy. It happens all the time in nature. Radioactive elements do it automatically themselves. So this EM will neutralize radioactivity, and you can actually see evidence of this if you go to the resources page on my website. The link to that is resources.freshandalive.com, and you can see there's a video there, a YouTube video of a Japanese farmer in Fukushima City, where the nuclear disaster happened, having his produce tested and his soil tested for radioactivity. When all the farmers around him cannot sell their produce because it's all radioactive, there's none detectable on his produce and on his crops. And it's because the only thing he did different was spray these microorganisms, this effective microorganisms from Teruo Higa, on his soil and on his plants and on his crops. No detectable radiation. Now that is way cool, and the thing that's even cooler is it is ridiculously cheap. You can buy a quart of this stuff for like $24-25, and you dilute it, like I said, thousands of parts of water to one part of the EM, and you can ferment it yourself and make more of it yourself. So it's a no-brainer. It's a no-brainer. So that's how you use this stuff. If you want to get all the details on how to brew it and how to use it, if you go to the EM1 product page on our website at freshandalive.com, it's got information there and uses directions on various things you can use it for. There's a lot of stuff you can use it for. I mean, you can use it in animal husbandry, you can use it in stalls, in barns to eliminate odors. You can improve animal health. You can give it to your cats, your dogs, your cows, your horses, your chickens, your fish, whatever. I mean, you can put it in aquariums. It's crazy what you can do with this stuff. Lots and lots of uses for it. And it's very empowering. That's why I teach people how to make it, how to brew it. If you want the detailed instructions on how to brew it, you can go to downloads.freshandalive.com, and we'll have the instructions there available for you. You can download it so you can learn how to brew it. I would say the main trick, we'll have more details and videos on how to brew this stuff, but the main trick with brewing it, it's kind of like brewing beer or wine if you've ever done that. You have to keep everything antiseptic. You've got to clean everything and disinfect it really, really well. If you get any contaminants in there, you'll screw it up and you'll get, you know, some nasty brew. But at any rate, that's how you use EM1. EM1 Pro, that is simply the same thing with aloe in it that Teruo Higa's company sells that is manufactured in a food-grade facility. The EM1 is not made in a food-grade facility, and so we cannot officially recommend it for human consumption, although I take it all the time, and most people take the EM1 all the time. Because if it was going to be contaminated, then you wouldn't have a viable brew. You wouldn't have a viable mixture there. It would go bad. So they have to keep it in sanitary conditions, but it's not made in an FDA-approved facility, so they can't recommend it for human consumption. So they came out with EM Pro, which has aloe in it, which, by the way, aloe is very high in monoatomic gold, which is extremely healing. So you've got this fermented aloe product that's high in antioxidants, it's high in probiotics, it's also high in ormus gold, and it's much more expensive. I think it's a half the bottle, 16-ounce bottle is half of what the EM1 sells for, and it's more expensive, so it's considered more expensive. And you can make your own, you know, you can brew your own. But for people that don't want to brew their own and they just want to buy it, it's there. So that's the difference between EM1 and EM1 Pro. But definitely investigate Teruo Higa and Effective Microorganisms and EM1, because you can use it for all kinds of life-saving things and detoxify your household with it. I'll be coming out this year with DVDs on how to detoxify your household too. But that's one of my favorite tricks, is using EM1. So anyway, I think that's all from the mailbag for now, and thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you again later.